The structures of reactive intermediates allow organic chemists to formulate hypotheses about how to affect the course of chemical reactions. That's why knowing the properties of reactive intermediates is so important. Let's take a look now at a reactive intermediate you may have never seen before, the carbene. See if you can use the structural properties we discuss here to solve the problem presented at the end of this webcast. The carbene is a neutral carbon, possessing two bonds and one lone pair. It contains three electron pair domains, or separate regions of electron density. Thus, we would expect it to be sp2 hybridized. This is confirmed by the flat geometry of the carbene. The bonds and lone pair all lie in the same plane. We would expect its lone pair to exhibit moderate nucleophilic reactivity, residing in an sp2 hybridized orbital. And the lone pair is indeed the homo of the carbene. The lowest empty, most electrophilic orbital of the carbene is the empty 2p orbital left behind after sp2 hybridization, perpendicular to the plane of the molecule. You might expect the reactivity of this orbital to be comparable to the empty 2p orbital of a carbocation, without the energy-lowering benefit of positive charge. Both carbenes and alkenes can act as both nucleophiles and electrophiles, thus they can combine with one another. The curved arrows for this process look like this. What does the transition state of this process look like? Two orientations are shown on this slide, expanded in the columns into two FMO interactions apiece. By carrying out an FMO analysis of the alkene and carbene, you should be able to determine which of the two orientations, the one represented by A and B, or the one represented by C and D, is the most favorable. Keep in mind the orientation of the FMOs of the carbene as you think about the orbital interactions here.